The thing about this Emmaus is this. It reminds me of the Holy Mass. You see? It reminds me of the Holy Mass, and I'll prove to you why it should. In fact, there's also a song, Taste and See the Goodness of the Lord. Taste and see, that's Psalm 34. That's Psalm 34.
Yep.
Now, there are stages of tasting and seeing the goodness of God. Okay? Stage one is the gathering right. Typically, when you go to Mass and you come early, you don't socialize, especially in the Mass itself. You don't talk. What do? You pray. You pray. Don't talk.
Should be a sign.
It's interesting, but even deacons and nuns, they talk. I see them. Now, where's this in the Bible? This is Luke. This is the beginning. This is the beginning of the Gospel. Now that very day, two of them were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus. Who joined them?
Jesus
himself joined them. What happens when you come to Mass? Jesus joins you. Jesus comes and joins you. You know that? You better believe it. That's why it's so good to come to Mass. Because you get to meet Jesus. Now, for us to gather at Mass, it's a set of knowledge by faith that when we gather together, it's with us. Remember, yes, last week I was talking to you, whenever two or more are gathered in His name, Book of Matthew, there He is in their midst, right? Mm-hmm. You see that in the Book of Matthew. Where is that? Matthew 18. Matthew 18.
So when you're praying by yourself, He's not there?
Yes, He is. Of course He is. Verse 20. Now, it's just a matter of recognizing Him. Because if you don't recognize Him, what good does it do? If you fail to recognize Jesus as He joins you in the Mass, oh, that's terrible. That means you didn't come to Bible class. You fail to recognize Him. When we say praise, what is one of the first things that the officiating priest says? The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Right? Sounds familiar. Who among you at the 11:30 Mass yesterday? Good. I was at the 11:30 and I came late, so. Yeah. So look at the gathering, right? The people gather and God is with them. Okay? Two. Penitential, right? This way you hear Kiri Eleiso. Right? God have mercy. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Or I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault. In my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. And I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, and all the eight saints. Right? Familiar? So in Luke 24:17, so you see that we're moving along here. Jesus asks, what are you discussing? So the Lord is asking Jesus, what's troubling you? What's troubling you? Jesus is asking you and me, what's troubling you? Well, you see, I'm thinking where to go because I want to go to a all-you-can-eat buffet. It's Mother's Day. I forgot the card. I forgot to send a card. It's troubling me. Oh, I didn't get the iPad that I promised. Oh, that's troubling me. So Jesus, the Lord, has joined you, and Jesus wants to know, what's the cause of your problem? What sort of trouble are you in? Are you affected? Does it show when you're distressed?
Sometimes.
Yeah, it does. You don't smile, right? Or you laugh alone. What's your behavior like when you're distressed? In their case, Cleopas and the companion, they were like hopeless. Are you the only one who have no idea what just happened in Jerusalem? The Messiah, the Nazarene, they crucified him. And they buried him. He died. That's it. That's why we're going back to Emmaus. Cleopas, by the way, is from Emmaus. That's why. You understand? That's it. Oh, forget it. I'm going back to Belleville. That's it. No more. He's dead. He's been crucified. I'm going back to Belleville. Picture Cleopas that way. He's going to Emmaus because that's where he lived. Who celebrates Mass? Who?
All of us.
You say all of us? What say you? Who celebrates the Mass?
Jesus.
Only Jesus celebrates Mass. Because Jesus is the only priest there is. He's the only priest. You know that?
So we're his guests.
Those men in black, we call them priests. But their priesthood is in union with the real union, in the real priesthood of Jesus Christ. You follow? Priest, king, and servant. Their being priests, their priesthood is in union with the priesthood of Jesus Christ. There's only one true priest, and that's Jesus Christ. You follow? In other words, if they're not in union with Jesus Christ, they're nothing. They're nothing.
They should change the rules where we don't call them Father. We call them Brother Ivan or Brother Mark. Instead, we have to call them Father Mark and Father Ivan. I find myself awkward saying it, and I don't feel happy about it.
I'd be happy to discuss that next week if you want me to. Yes, it's good to call them Father.
Yes. But then it says, the Bible says, you're not supposed to call anyone Father, but God Father.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm
and the Bible also says,
many
places, the Bible says, you can call, Paul was saying, call me Father. Mm-hmm. Abraham says, I'm your Father. There are even more places in the Bible that says, call people Father.
Okay.
We'll take that up. Today we'll talk about in material, the materials, I don't know if you read it, purgatory. You notice it? In the materials, I show you how to defend the concept of purgatory in the Bible. It's right there.
Yes, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So where are you going with your life? Jesus is the way, he's the ship gate. You better make sure that your life is headed towards him. Because it's the only way to salvation. Jesus is the only way to eternal life. There's no other way. Stage 3. Return to God. Liturgy of the Word. What is so what happened here? Sorry, I'm boring you. So Liturgy of the Word, Luke 24, 27, and also verse 32. So Jesus is trying to explain, interpret the prophecies in the Old Testament pertaining to him. That's what he did. Remember, they could not recognize him. So you see that there was liturgy of the word. It was Jesus that read to them interpretations of the Old Testament prophesying about the coming Messiah. And so too for us in the Mass.
For the needs.
Intercessory. Intercessory prayers. Intercessory. Okay, we'll see you in the next segment.